Alright you guys, so while I've been working on the laptop, I actually just made a new friend. I have a feeling, bro, we're gonna be good friends.
I think we're best friends.
Bro. Yeah, bro, like, we're gonna be very good friends 100%. For a long time. Sadiq, you wanna give them a little story of how this just happened?
Okay, so I saw Josh recording a video and I just knew bro's gonna be successful. I already thought he had like a couple billion subscribers.
Appreciate that.
But I just saw how like fluent you were with like how you do your stuff. And I had to come over, I had to ask, bro, like, how did you get so famous? And I came over and, like, the nicest, can I curse?
Yeah, yeah.
The nicest fucking guy on the planet. Best advice, everything. Like, if you're watching this video now, you're hella lucky. And, like, I just came over, shot my shot, came to chat to bro, and now I've got a new brother.
So yeah.
It's amazing.
New brother, bro. Yeah. Come on. Pleasure meeting you, bro.
My guy, pleasure. It's
yeah.
a pleasure.
So we're just finishing up, chopping it up over here. Sadiq's gonna be boarding soon and I'm gonna be boarding in about an hour as well. So like I said, guys, in like my previous videos, just investing into your environment, investing into travel, like these are the experiences that you guys will get when you invest into yourself. You'll meet like-minded individuals as you go. It's like you were saying before, it's just like, the people that are meant to be in your life are going to be there.
You'll just attract them, bro.
Exactly. That's
fundamentally how it goes.
Exactly. It's like, we've only known each other for like, what, 10, 15 minutes?
It feels like it's been 10,
yeah,
15 years.
Yeah, it's been like years, bro. Yeah. Anyways, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up, and then I'll see you when I'm back in Miami. How do you know the way I feel?
You got me losing my mind. Yo, what's good, my people? It's actually been just about a week since I've picked up this camera. The original game plan was to actually start filming the day after I got back from Dubai and just hit the ground running. But honestly, I just was not fully recovered. I still was feeling sick. And the traveling and readjusting back to the Miami time zone didn't help my case either. Like, your boy was just not feeling good. My face was stuffy. It looked like I gained weight because of all the congestion. And yeah, it just was not a good time to be on camera. But it's been a few days now. I feel a whole lot better. I actually just got back home from work. For those of you guys who are curious what I currently do, I'm actually in the service department at Lucid Motors. I actually have a clip somewhere on my phone. For those of you guys who are curious like what my day-to-day looks like, I'll actually throw it in right here.
I think I'm gonna need this clip one day. I just don't know what for, but I'm just gonna capture day in the life of what I'm doing right now at work. So we just received a shipment of cars from the factory. And right now I just did an inspection of each car that came in. So 6 came in today. I basically did all the paperwork at the inspections. And I also am uploading all of the details, basically, like example, like the BOL of the cars, and just uploading them to the system, to the computer. And also took the intake pictures as well. So that's basically what I do. At least that's part of what I do. So that's what today is looking like. I had to inspect 6 cars, upload all the details to the systems and make sure that they have everything that they need from the factory, like the plate covers, wheel covers, accessories, to make sure that when the technicians do the PDI, the pre-delivery inspections, they know what it is that they have to work on.
So yeah, guys, that's a little bit of what I do day to day. And also, I got really good news, at least for me. For those of you guys who don't know, I actually have a 2023 Audi A5. Now, this car used to be my daily, but once I started to invest into a business coach, a health and physique coach, I started to buy new gear such as this MacBook. I started to invest into software that required, you know, a monthly bill. All of this stuff started piling up and I realized, like, look, I can't really afford everything, if I'm being totally honest. So I decided to put the car up on Turo. I actually have a partner who manages my car, who manages my customers, who manages everything for me, and I just give him a percentage. So the car pays for itself now. It's pretty much out most of the time. At the end of the month, it does give me a little bit of profit for the most part.
But even then, I don't see the profit. I literally don't get to enjoy the money because it gets invested back into myself. But I finally got it back. I'm actually getting it detailed tomorrow morning, which I'll show you guys once it's all cleaned up. It's a really cool car. So yeah, guys, that's a little bit more about me. I'm really happy right now. I finally get to enjoy my car. It's been such a long time. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead, unwind, change, probably do another editing session on the computer, and yeah, I'll see you guys soon.
Yo.
Yo, what's up, bro?
What time are you now, mate? 5 a.m.
Yeah, it's 5 a.m. over here. Yo, before we start real quick, I've actually been recording. You want to say hi to my people?
Yo, man. all on the mission.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah.
You see, all your boys now can see you killing it at 5 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah, very true, very true. We try, man.
No excuses from the boys,
man. Yeah. What's up, bro? How's she looking? Damn, bro, she looks good, man.
A1, bro. I could actually see my wheels again. Insane. Yeah, bro. Thank you, Anthony. Oh, man. Amazing, bro. You want to tell the people what you did to the car?
We did a iron decon, clay bar, and the wheels got detailed inside the barrel everywhere.
It's Steeze Detailing, bro. Shout out to Steeze.
Around here, carpets were taken off, scrubbed down. I'm getting full for you. For
your drive. Appreciate it, man. Warming appreciate it. Man, glass, crisp.
Glass, all the glass, not just some, all of them.
There you go.
Interior got wiped down twice.
Nice.
Still some water in there, but nice. It's
dry. It's all right.
Paint's super smooth. I iron deconned it, clay barred it, and sealed it with a SiO2 sealant. Same ingredient found in the ceramic coatings.
A1, bro.
Always, man, since day one for you.
Since day one, bro. If you ever need a detail and you're local here in Miami, hit up Steeze Detailing. I'll go ahead and add his contact information here and in the description below. Yeah, finally got the car back. It's finally looking like mine again, and I'm gonna enjoy the next few days with it. So yeah, guys, I'll see you guys soon. All right, you guys, so I just finished up a quick run here at the Gables in Merrick Park. I'm just hanging out here in the back of the trunk. Perks of a hatchback, bro. But right now it is 11:21 in the morning. I'm just gonna rest up now, enjoy some time in the sun, and then I'm gonna go ahead, shower, hit the steam, and then do some errands from there. So that's what the day's looking like so far. And also, guys, for any of you guys who are just in a bit of a pickle, where things are a bit overwhelming with the personal life or with the office life, and you're just trying to get some kind of sense of direction, honestly, just break a sweat, bro. Not saying you can have everything figured out, but it definitely clears up your head and lets you think from a better position. So camera's getting hot, it's giving me a warning light. I'm gonna go ahead and clean up here. I even brought the tripod with me, bro, just for the angles, the things us YouTubers have to do to get the angles, bro. Insane. But yeah, I'm gonna get to it, and then I'll keep you guys updated as I go. All right, you guys, so I'm all showered and freshened up, had a really nice run, and after I cleaned up from Equinox, I actually went to go run some errands. So in between these errands, I really don't know why, maybe it was just like the environment that I was in, maybe, I really don't know, but some old memories basically resurfaced while I was just going on about my day. And I'm not gonna lie, it kind of opened up some old wounds, kind of reopened some cuts. It got me thinking about life. Specifically, what I was thinking about was just like, man, there's certain people in my life that I used to spend so much time with. There's certain people that used to be down for the ride and, do everything with me, be there for me. Yeah, just really be present in my life and just, talk almost on a daily basis. And now that is no longer the case with, some of these people that I think about. Not all of them ended in a bad way, or not all of them
were ended because of bad terms. Some of us just kind of drifted apart from each other because I have my own thing. Some of my other friends have their own thing. It really made me realize that when your priorities shift, when you change what matters the most to you and you, you know, approach something new, maybe you have a new goal, all of a sudden, when, like, yeah, it's all fun and games, like when you tell your friends that, hey, you know, this is what I'm gonna do, I have a new goal, you know, I really want to do this, they're all supportive. And at least I'm speaking from my experience, like my friends would be supportive and, you know, like, yeah, go do it, bro, you know, like, we're rooting for you, all that, that kind of energy. But once you really get serious about it, you know, they're nowhere to be found. And it's crazy. It's just like, that's when you really need them the most, because this like whole YouTube journey, or not even just about the YouTube journey, man, just life, like it's crazy how, at least in my experience, just a lot of people really disappear when you hit a new territory of dedication and, you know, change, or trying to make a change in your life. Like, you'll know that you're really serious about it when things don't necessarily like work the way they used to with your friendships or, you know, certain relationships that you have. You kind of get to this place where it's lonely because you're trying to do something that probably hasn't been done before, or it's just not exactly common where you're from or who you usually surround yourself with. And yeah, it just, it gets really, really fucking dark, man. It gets draining, bro, like when you try to do something different, and you're often alone most of the time, but that vision is what really keeps us going. I really wish there were certain people in my life right now, while I'm really trying to figure all of this out, but maybe that's God's way. At least the way I want to interpret it is that maybe he's just taking away everything from me in the meantime, so I could really focus on the things that will drive progress towards the YouTube channel, my personal development, business. You know, maybe he's stripping everything and isolating me because he wants me to focus. That's how I'm choosing to interpret everything that's going on in my life right now. Just being alone, grinding away, doing a lot of things that a lot of my friends and family don't understand, doing things that I prioritize so much and care for so much, but to them, you know, they think of it very lightly. That's really the stage that I'm at right now, guys. That's the reality of things. The piece of advice that I just want to give you is that if you are embarking a new journey, it will get lonely, but you just have to see it through. Like, you really have to see that light at the end of the tunnel. And for me, it's just that I keep locking into that vision that I see here in my head, like the physical reality. Like, I can vividly see it, I can vividly feel it, and I can vividly like live it in my mind. For me to be able to see that and then not go all in all the way and just kind of quit halfway, dude, I would live in so much regret. Like, I could not live with myself. There's a lot of sacrifices that I have to make this year, and I promise you guys, I can't talk about everything now, but I promise as I figure things out and as I get into the motions of things, I can really bring more transparency. But yeah, there's a lot of sacrifice that will be required this year. And even, dude, like that car that you guys saw, it's a nice car, but I might have to give that up too. Like, there's just so much that I'm willing to give up to make sure that this channel stays alive and it flourishes and succeeds. But yeah, man, I'm kind of venting right now, but like, yeah, that's the truth, man. I just really wish there were certain people around at this point in my life. We gotta keep carrying on, and you know, I gotta make sure that I really fulfill everything, or at least do my absolute best to fulfill everything for myself. When you do revisit those old memories that open up some old cuts and wounds, man, you gotta use it to fuel you and to push you to go even harder at the things that you're striving for. Don't use it to ponder. Because I almost caught myself. I almost caught myself kind of just, you know, down and about, and I was like, no, like, I can't. Our time is finite. Like, none of this is guaranteed. It's just like, for all I know, I could go tomorrow. And man, I'm getting so deep in this conversation, but it's so fucking true, bro. It's just like, none of this is guaranteed. It's just like, so you got to keep that at the forefront of your mind so you don't waste any of the time that you do have. Like, time is like the most precious thing that we do have. So yeah, guys, that's it for this rant. I'm gonna get back to editing, and then I'll see you guys after I'm done. Alright you guys, so hopefully the background noise isn't too bad since I'm outside. I'm actually at one of my favorite restaurants here right now in Miami, and that is Palo Quemao. So this is the place. It's actually a Colombian restaurant, so it's a good way to unwind for the rest of the evening. I've just been working really hard, guys, and good way to treat myself, especially for having been fasted for over 24 hours. Like, I literally have been running off of 3 cups of coffee and a gallon of water for the day. So gonna go ahead and wait for my food. I already ordered, but in the meantime, guys, just wanted to talk to you and just give you the reality of things. This is kind of what the day-to-day looks like here in Miami. There's not much to it right now, man. It's very rinse and repeat. Just wake up, work, make YouTube videos, work on myself, coach my people, get coached, and that's basically what the next few months are also going to look like. One thing that I'll say, guys, is like, no matter what you're doing, if you just want to further your self-development journey, like if you just want to get back into shape, you want to start trying to dress nicer, improve your appearance, socialize more, whatever it is that you're trying to improve on, start that side business or that main business, delve into something completely brand new, take some kind of risk, you're always going to have to leave your comfort zone. That's just part of it. And the reason why I'm bringing that up now is because I realized, like, yo, I'm in like the middle of a restaurant where there's a bunch of people around looking at me, and I'm like, it's crazy how I don't even care anymore, and I don't mind talking to the camera publicly. And that's because I've gone out of my way multiple times to just get out of my comfort zone. And that's an essential skill that you need to develop in life whenever it comes to trying something new, or if you want to hit new push past new boundaries in life. You really have to get out of your comfort zone. And I would say the best way to do that is to start focusing on the small wins. Just do things little by little and do things gradually. Yeah, guys, that's really all of the advice that I have for you. The food finally got here, guys, so I'll show you real quick. So this is what I got. I got me a bandeja paisa, and then I got me some tequeños. So I'm gonna go on ahead and finish up this dinner and enjoy myself for the rest of this evening, and I'll see you guys soon. All right, you guys, so I'm finally back home now, just editing away on the computer, just actually putting the final touches together for this video that you guys are watching. So that basically concludes the day. It's how the rest of this evening is gonna go. And guys, that's basically it. Like, this was more of a chill vlog. I know it's not as like busy compared to the previous vlogs that I've been posting. So yeah, I appreciate you guys tuning in. For those of you who keep coming around and watching to the end, it really does mean a lot to me that you guys are taking the time to invest into my videos. So I'm very appreciative of that. And also, we did hit 1K subs, and that I'm really, really, really grateful for. Like, I know it's not a lot for some, and to some people it's like light work to get 1K subs, but for me it was really difficult because I've been on and off for 2 years, and now that I'm actually putting real effort into this, I've just seen the growth like this. So 1K, man, like, finally just seeing that letter K, it makes me feel a little bit more legitimate, I'm not gonna lie. So I'm really thankful for that, guys. I do want to do some kind of giveaway. I want to do a $150 giveaway in like a Nike gift card or a Zara gift card, winner picks. So it's just, that's my idea for now, because a lot of you guys who watch me are in this like self-development space. A lot of you guys are like athletes, and a lot of you guys are like entrepreneurs or just, like fashion and stuff. So I feel like giving you that room of choice can really help you out. So I'll figure out the details in this giveaway. It's probably going to be on my Instagram. So just follow me on Instagram at it's Josh Valerian. And then just stay tuned on that for the $150 gift card giveaway. And if you're selected, you'll have that choice of Nike or Zara. So I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Thank you again. And yeah, I'll see you on the next video.